at the press school, and one thing I enjoyed about youth court was the jail tour.
I'm Barbara. I'm a freshman at Mercer High School, and I learned court things.
I'm Ryan Bloomer. I'm a freshman at Mayfair High School, and I learned a lot of the jail tour.
I'm Nicole Burns. I'm a seventh grader at Mercer Middle School, and I learned a lot about the prosecution.
I'm Teresa. I go to Mercer High School, and I learned a lot from the judge.
I'm Sam. I go to HJ12, and I learned a lot about the court system.
I'm Miriam. I'm a freshman at Mayfair High School, and I learned a lot about the defense team.
I'm Meredith. I'm a sophomore at Carmel High School, and I learned a lot at the county court observation.
I'm Ricardo Perez, and I learned a lot about the prosecution.
I'm Aiden. I go to Mayfair Public School in the eighth grade, and I learned about how the court system works.
I'm Fernando. I go to Brewster High School. I'm a freshman, and I learned a lot about the defense attorney.
I'm Alfonso. I go to Henry Middle School, and I learned a lot about prosecution.
I'm William Lynch, and I go to Mayfair Middle School in seventh grade, and I learned a lot about different jobs.
I'm Alonzo Mathmore, and I go to Brewster High School, and I learned a lot on the county jail tour.
I'm Selena. I go to Mayfair Middle School, and I learned a lot about the jail tour.
I'm Christo Streetsville, so I go to George Fisher Middle School. I'm in seventh grade, and I learned about the rule of prosecution.
I'm Gabby. I go to HJ12, and I learned a lot about the prosecution.
I'm Gabby Rowe. I go to Mayfair Middle School. I'm in eighth grade, and I learned a lot about the court clerk.
I'm Gabby Rowe. I go to Rooster High School, and I'm a freshman, and I learned a lot about the court system.
I'm Sean Ryan. I'm a sophomore at Mayfair High School, and I learned a lot about the jail tour.
Hi, I'm Thomas. I'm a freshman at Brewster High School, and I learned a lot about the defense.
Hi, I'm Drake Marie. I go to Brewster High School. I'm a junior, and I learned a lot about prosecution.
Hi, my name is Emily. I go to HJ12, and I learned more about the court system.
Patrick McGee. I'm a sophomore at Mayfair High School. I learned a lot about being a judge.
Thank you, graduates, and congratulations. I would now like to ask youth court member Chris Ray to continue our ceremony.
Good evening, my name is Chris. I'm a senior at Brewster High School. This is my fourth year in youth court. It's the hard work and dedication of our youth that has brought us here this evening. Youth court shares its success with our families and community leaders. Please hold your applause as we would like to thank and acknowledge our honored guests for their continued support of our program. Congressman Sean Maloney, represented by Nancy Montgomery. New York State Assemblywoman Sandy Gaylor. Assemblyman Dr. Stephen Katz, a failing and Supreme Court Judge John W. Sweeney, who is a proud youth court parent, Putnam County Executive Mary Ellen O'Dell, Putnam County Supreme Court Victor Grossman, Putnam County Sheriff Donald Smith, County Court Judge James F. Reese, also a proud youth court parent, District Attorney Adam Levy, and Assistant DA Lisa Ortolano, Legislator Sam Oliverio, Legislator Barbara J. Sukumari, Legislator Ginny Nasserino, Legislator Carl L. Albano, Legislator Denny Lupo, Legislator Roger Gross, Legislator Kevin L. Wright, Commissioner of Social Services, Mental Health and Bureau, Michael J. Piazza, also a proud youth court parent, Deputy Commissioner of Social Services, Mental Health and Bureau, Joseph DiMarzo, and a proud parent of a youth court member, Putnam County Clerk Dennis Sam, Town of Carmel Supervisor Ken Schmidt, Commissioner of Finance William Carlin, also a proud youth court parent, Town of Carmel Clerk Ann Spofford, Town of Carmel Judge Thomas Jacobellis, Town of Carmel Judge Joseph Spofford, Town of Kent Judge Kevin Dushkoff, Probation Director Jean Funicelli, Probation Officer April Brock, Youth Bureau Director Janine Cunningham, from the Putnam County Sheriff's Department, Protection Officer Stephen Toth, also proud youth corps parent. Community Resource Officer Deputy Michael Schmidt. Lieutenant Sheila Hanley, whom we would like to welcome back. From the New York State Bar Association, Joseph Talk, also a proud youth corps parent. From the Dispute Resolution Center, Hans Schwein. Members of our youth bureau staff and youth board. Mentoring coordinator, Charlissa Thatcher, and we are proud to say that one of our graduates, one of our first graduates, and newly elected Putnam County Clerk, Michael Bartoloni, and Michael Simo, former legislator and one of the founders of Youth Corps. Thank you for all being here and always supporting us.
I want to first congratulate our graduates and all of our parents and supporters of our children. This is such a great time for them. It's just the beginning of their sort of indoctrination into the law and being young adults, and I think it's a wonderful evening. At this time, we would like to take a few minutes to thank someone very special to the Putnam County Youth Bureau, and that's Legislator Sam Oliverio. Sam's dad, Maximo, started the program back in 1987, and Sam has followed his father's footsteps in supporting this program, and Sam, I know your dad would be very proud of you. Sam has been a legislator since 1997 to current, and please, Sam, we'd like to invite you up to accept the plaque on behalf of the Youth Bureau and all the for all your dedication and support to our program.
Great honor that you've earned. God bless you all. Thank you.
graduates, of course, congratulations on your good choices that so far it seems that you're able to make, and to the parents. I've raised two of my own, and I know that the challenges every day, every morning, are never, you know, that day at the end of the day, you say, wow, I didn't really expect today to end up the way it did, for good and for bad. And I think that we all know what we face all comes down to making good decisions and making good choices. And as a county executive, our administration has really focused quite a bit of attention on our youth because we view them as our greatest asset and we view them as our future. And one of our programs that I'm most proud of with the collaboration of the legislature is the pilot program. And it's called the pilot for a reason. It's an acronym, meaning Putnam invests in leaders of tomorrow. And we believe that the best resource for our county government and representation moving forward is right here. And we example and invite all of you to consider an opportunity in joining us here in county government and as an intern, whether it's in a summer program or we have some programs throughout the year. Many are paid if you're in college. You can make a little salary. Parents, I know that that helps you. And it can also help your curriculum moving forward in credits. And it also is a resume builder. But mostly, I look at it as an opportunity to build our succession plan. To make sure, as county government, we all know that as elected officials, we come and go, but the people will always be here. I feel responsible that the leadership that I'm building now for the future is strong and it's one of our own. So the pilot program is out there now. You can certainly go on the website, PutnamCountyNY.gov, read about it, reach out to our personnel director, Joe DeMars, or Mike Gals, or any of us really here. And please take advantage of joining us in county government. And I think already you have a little bit of an idea of the legal system, but also you can find the rewards of public service. And Sam will tell you that as well. As he looks back on his career, I think the one thing he'll note the most was it was the opportunity to give back. So Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah to everyone, and thank you to all, to the whole team for putting this night together. Thank you.
And Sam, before I say a word of thanks to you, I do want to make the comment to the graduates. As it was mentioned, I am a proud parent of a U-Fort graduate, and it's a very poignant moment for me tonight to see you here and all the U-Fort graduations, because what you have done and the work you have achieved and what you've learned from Barbara has helped you, the positive development that it gives you will stand in great stead for you all of your life, and I know that for a fact. So congratulations on all your work that you've done. And as a result, too, congratulations to you, Sam. And thanks to you for the work. Just like, as was said, you know, I was around when your father and Mike were very supportive of the Youth Bureau. But even before that, I think you and I go back to before I was commissioner, before you were legislator, we worked together in the school district on several issues. So we go back a long, long way. And for the past 18 years, through all kinds of, no matter all the changes that take place, we could always be assured that you would be the chairman of the Health, Social Welfare, and Education Committee.
Yes.
And as such, your support and willingness to help all of us in the health departments and the mental health department, social services, and the Youth Bureau has always been very, very gratifying to us. And we appreciate all that you've done. We want to thank you, too.
Thank you.
Congratulate our graduates. I mean, you guys could do it any day. You did a great job. And this was my first Youth Corps
I would now like to ask Youth Corps member Megan Mamola to continue our ceremony. Activities that will prepare them for the courtroom. Our graduates visited the Town of Carmel Justice Court, where they sat behind Judge Spofford and Judge Jack Bellis to observe actual court proceedings. And to help them understand the consequences of their actions, they took a tour of the Putnam County Correctional Facility with Officer Took. For the past 10 weeks, our graduates addressed an actual case that was referred to youth court by the probation department. Because all of our cases are confidential, names and locations have been changed. The graduates worked on the case of criminal sale of a controlled substance involving a 15-year-old defendant that we called Tony Doe. The defendant, Tony Doe, took prescription pills and alcohol from home and then distributed those drugs to other students at school, one of them who was taken to the hospital. Prescription drug abuse is an increasingly deadly problem in our country, in our schools. Recreational use of any prescription drugs is incredibly dangerous, and teens are finding these drugs right in their own homes. The defendant in our case was charged with the criminal sale of a controlled substance in the fifth degree, Penal Law Section 220.31, Class D felony, with the proper approval of this case, and the proper approval of this case was referred to youth court by Putnam County Probation Department. Just a few weeks ago, the graduates took the two-part bar exam. One part of the bar exam was a trial presentation based on this case. With assistance of our expert speakers, the graduates wrote their own defense and prosecution statements. Part two was an actual written bar exam.
This year, our youth court graduates demonstrated their role in helping their peers understand the consequences of their actions and how they can move forward in a positive way. And we're here today to acknowledge and applaud their hard work and dedication. Graduates, we've now successfully completed your 10-week training, and we are happy to make this announcement. After observing your mock trials and grading your exams, we're pleased to say you all passed the bar exam. And just to share a little note about our program, over the course of 27 years, Youth Corps have trained over 1,200 youth throughout the Putnam County. We've heard close to 500 Youth Corps cases. For the past 27 years, Youth Corps members have volunteered 425,000 community service hours to Putnam County. That is amazing. But as Youth Corps members, we know our program would not be a success if it was without our education and knowledge we received during training from the experts in our community. So on behalf of our Youth Corps graduates and members, we would like to take a moment to acknowledge the experts responsible for this year's training. You can please stand as I call your name. Assistant District Attorney Lisa Orlano. For teaching us the importance of representing the victim and seeking justice in the role of prosecution. Thank you, Ms. Orlando.
give a special thanks to our parents and guardians for their ongoing support. At this time, we would like to ask the parents and the guardians of this year's graduates to please stand and be recognized. Parents, would you please stand?
It is a privilege, first off, to work with your kids, these young students, and I've learned a lot. And I've had many years to work with the Youth Corps program. I want to thank Barbara and Tam for what they do and all the support the community leaders provide for the Youth Corps. I will say that if you take a look at the recent developments, just in the newspaper, any day, and some of the decisions the young people are making that you read about, I know one thing for sure. Putnam County is in good shape with these students because they make some great decisions, and I'm telling you, I am proud to have worked with them, and I can't thank the parents, the families enough for their dedication in getting here each and every week. It means a lot, and for our future. I want to thank you for that. Thank you very much.
Town Corps, we are very pleased, very proud to play a very small part in the Youth Corps program. I want to thank Barbara Reed for inviting the Quarmel Corps to participate in the program. What we find amongst the students in the Youth Corps program is that they tend to be the best and the brightest of the students in our community. And we certainly congratulate you on your achievement. It's a very rigorous program, it's a very thorough program, and for you to complete the program and to graduate really is a comment upon your character and your discipline and your work ethic and attitude. So I'd like to encourage you to continue in your legal studies, and we expect that at some point you'll be the future leaders in our community, future leaders in our justice system. So congratulations, good luck in your future study of the law. Thank you.
That come in and train and educate the students. Can I share with you? I want to thank each and every one of you. You have taught me a lot about compassion, decency, respect, and listening. And I want to thank you very much for that. So if you would, please stand up. Raise your right hand. And please repeat after me. I state your first name. I
am Andrew Brother.
Do hereby promise to uphold.
Do hereby promise to uphold.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the bylaws.
And the bylaws.
Of the Putnam County Youth Corps Program.
Of the Putnam County Youth Corps Program.
And that I will fulfill.
And that I will fulfill.
My duties as youth corps member.
My duties as a youth corps member.
In a respectful manner.
In a respectful manner.
Congratulations.
Are making Putnam County a better place, and your dedication in these past 10
Chief of Staff, Tara Keegan, also a youth court alumni.
Given some critique sheets tonight on the tour of the jail, and as I came in, I was asked to kind of share with you some of the comments from the critique sheets. And I'll just summarize them because there's so many of them, I've been accused of being up here too long. So let me just say, I'm always accused of being up here too long. But they were really interesting comments. You know, some of them talked about it was a little bit scary, but it was also cool. And there were comments about the separation. That was really the overarching comment. It wasn't that the jail was a bad place. It was the fact that when those doors clang, they're very, very heavy. And I think most of the youth court members said they certainly didn't mind visiting, but they really wouldn't want to be here. And the separation was really the thing that I think they saw. You know, I never attend a youth court graduation without reflecting back on a prayer breakfast that Governor Pataki had several years ago in Albany. The guest speakers at that prayer breakfast were the rabbi and the deacon, and they gave a very inspirational speech that early morning in Albany. But the thing that I always think of when I think of youth court is the story they told about the Cherokee chief, who was a grandfather, and his grandson. And they told, and by the way, I researched this, and I attribute it to them. It's actually on the internet, and the author is anonymous. But the story is the Cherokee chief and his grandson go for a walk in the woods. And the grandfather's getting old, and he wants to leave something with his grandson. He wants to impart some wisdom and some knowledge to his grandson. And they talk about many things, and they come to this topic of good and evil. And the grandson asks, other chief says, grandson, it's like having two wolves inside of each of us. There are two wolves inside of each of us. One wolf is the bad wolf, and that's the wolf that is about darkness, about evil, about lies, about jealousy, about sorrow, about envy, resentment, inferiority, false pride, and ego. Everything that is not good in the world. And the second wolf is about everything that is good in the world. It's about light, truth, justice, righteousness, honor, dignity, and respect. And he said, these two wolves are in all of us, and they're competing for control of our soul. And the grandson looks up at his grandfather and he says, grandfather, which wolf will win? The grandfather looks back at him and says, the one we feed, my grandson, the one we feed. So to the parents here tonight, I just want to say by supporting your youngster in the youth court, you are feeding your children, you're feeding the good wolf, the idea of truth, justice, righteousness, honor, and integrity. And that's what youth court is all about to me. So tonight, I certainly want to congratulate our county executive for supporting this program, our legislature, our youth bureau, Joe, Janine, Barbara, and Pamela, everyone who puts their heart and soul in this program. We're very, very proud of this program. And we believe that this program supports the future of America, which are our young people. Congratulations to you all. May you continue to work on youth court, and may you all be successful in your walk in life. May God bless you. May God bless your parents. I join the county executive in wishing everyone a happy Hanukkah, a Merry Christmas, a joyous holiday season, and every good wish for goodness in the new year. May God bless you all. Thank you.
Student intern from the Mayapak High School WISE program. And I will say that many of the students from the WISE program have come from the youth court and volunteered and worked in my office over the past 10 years. I'm also proud to say that I've been part of this program for about 20 years. Barbara Reitz is the definition of commitment to youth. And I think she deserves a standing ovation. Children are committed, they're here. But if you don't have somebody at the helm organizing, focusing your kids on what the right thing is, then we don't have a program. The legislature supports this program because of people like Barbara and Pam, who's been working on the program. So all in all, I'm just going to say this is a tremendous program. You should be proud of your children. You should be proud of yourselves for getting them here every Wednesday night for the past 10 weeks. Because, you know, it does make a difference in their lives. And I'm proud to say, as I said, I have three from this program, and I'll continue volunteering for this program because these kids are where the future lies. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Topps. And last but certainly not least, one of our first youth court
congratulate each and every one of you and your parents and guardians for coming this far in the program. I think this is a phenomenal opportunity. And whether you embarked on it because you have some interest in the legal system and the justice system, you're just looking to get some experience, some life experience, I think you've made a very wise choice. And I think you've reached this point where you're graduating and now ready to participate in the system. And the best advice I can give you is soak it up. Get as much of it as you can. As was just mentioned, I am youth privilege. I graduated from the first class, and I served all the way through my senior year in high school. I had an interest in the law, so I thought it would be a nice thing to try out. And I'll tell you, other than making my decision that I wanted to pursue a career in the law, the greatest thing that I grasped from it is the great feeling that you get and the satisfaction that you get from serving your community and serving your public. And that is phenomenal. And that is something that I take with me every day. I never thought when I was sitting where you're sitting right now that I would be standing right here 27 years later, but that's the way it goes, and it's phenomenal. And this is a great path in life for you to take. I wish you all the best of luck. Congratulations. Thank you very much to the county government, the executive legislature, the youth bureau, and Barbara especially for keeping this going. This is one of the greatest programs out there, and we are truly proud to have it here in Putnam County. Thank you.
This year's honored guests, please stand for presenting their congratulations to the newest youth corps members. Nicholas Balzano.
Congratulations. Perez. Positive choices in the future and for their future. Before we say goodnight, we would like to